You have found that when finding a limit using a calculator, you may either approach it numerically by drawing a table, or you can do it graphically by drawing a graph. There are sometimes, though, you do not get to use a calculator. So, how do you find a limit when you don't have a calculator available? There are actually several different methods. In this lesson, you'll be able to find a limit using direct substitution. Okay, basically, direct substitution is when you are just going to try to, if x approaches 3, you're just going to try to plug 3 into the equation. If x is approaching 5, you'll just try to plug 5 into the equation. And then basically, the notes that are on this screen, when we do that, it pretty much works for polynomial and rational functions, and it can be used for radical functions if the root is odd. You don't really have to worry about that too much because you're just going to try to plug it in, and if it works, you'll use it, and if it doesn't, then you'll try one of our other methods. So when you're going to use direct substitution again, all you're going to do is plug in the x value directly into the equation. So let's try a few examples. Okay, in the first example, it says to find the limit as x approaches 5 of 3x minus 8 over x plus 3. So what we want to do is just go into that function, and we're going to try to substitute in the x value of 5. So we'll put 3 times the x value of 5 minus 8 over 5 plus 3. And then we're just going to see if we can work it out, which we definitely can. 3 times 5 is 15, minus 8 is 7. And then 5 plus 3 is 8. So we were actually able to find an answer. So that is my limit. Okay, the next one, the limit as x approaches negative 4. Again, we're just going to try to plug in negative 4 for the x's and see if we can get an answer. So I'll put negative 4 in for the x, all over negative 4. Negative 4 plus 5 is 1, so we're going to be looking for the, oops, we're going to be looking for the cube root of 1. The cube root of 1 is what times what times what would give us 1. That will be 1 over negative 4. And since I was able to find an answer, that was the limit. If when you do this, you're not actually able to find an answer, that doesn't mean that the limit does not exist. It just means that you can't use this method to try to find the answer. But you'll always want to start your limit problems by actually doing it this method. So now you should be able to find a limit using direct substitution.